Hello everyone, iCool Tech here. Now iPadOS 17.1 has just released to the general public, and in this video I'm going to be covering how it performs, what the battery life is like, if the iPad overheats at all, and any bugs that have been fixed or that still remain. Anyways, if you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below for more content just like this, with every new iOS release going forward, and I will see you at the end of the video. Let's go. So starting off with the performance, there is absolutely zero change coming from any other iOS 17 release on my iPad. I haven't come across a single task that iPadOS 17.1 can't handle that earlier versions could, so the change isn't particularly a bad thing here, or the lack of change. Similar to performance, my iPad does not feel any snappier with iPadOS 17.1 than previous iOS 17 releases, but iPadOS 17.1 is very, very, very smooth, so this is not a bad thing at all either. Now as for things like RAM management, of course, iPadOS 17.1 performs great with keeping apps open in the background for extended periods of time. I've noticed zero app reloads after having apps idle in the background for pretty long periods of time, and I cannot say that there is any improvement over iPadOS 17.0 since I have not seen any, but it has definitely not gotten worse. Now, as far as the battery life is concerned, I have noticed negligible change here as well. I end the day off with quite a bit of battery left to spare still. However, the standby drain still exists and costs me about 10-15% per night left off the charger. Now, with this said, I still have no issue getting through the day or even two, or even sometimes three. Now, I've also not noticed my iPad get warm at all during light or even intense use. Now keep in mind that as soon as you do update your iPad, and this goes with any other device as well, you may experience some slight overheating or battery drain because the device goes through what's called indexing, where it deletes unused files and reorganizes a lot of things in the file system. So this is completely normal and would clear up within a day or two. Now, just like iOS 17.1, iPadOS 17.1 also has some bug fixes in it as well. So it resolves an issue where the incoming caller names may not appear when on another call. It addresses an issue where custom and purchased ringtones may not appear as options in settings, and it fixes an issue where the keyboard may be less responsive. However, there are still a couple of issues with iPadOS 17.1 that have been here for quite a while now and have not been resolved. The first one, just like iOS, the notification center gets completely glitched out when swiping up. As you can see here with the no notifications text, the actual notifications will jump all over the place and is just really, really affecting the quality of life here, and I hope to see that fixed soon. Now, the second issue actually has to do with the Magic Keyboard. When you're in the control center and you long click on a platter here, it actually will disappear completely and won't come back until you restart the iPad. Now, this is an issue that's been going on for quite a while for me, and I haven't seen anyone else talking about it, but it is quite annoying, and I have tried reporting it to Apple with no luck. So hopefully that will be fixed soon as well. Alright everyone, that is iOS 17.1 on the iPad. Now, iPadOS 17.1 brings some new features and a lot of fixes, and overall, it is a very, very, very stable and great iPadOS release. So if you're already on an iPadOS 17 release, I definitely recommend updating to this latest public release, if you haven't already, of course. And if you're on iPadOS 16 and you've been waiting for maybe some of the bugs to be ironed out, I think now's a pretty good time to update because iPadOS 17.1 has really fixed the few but definite bugs that users have complained about. Anyways, that is all I have for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. I will see you in the next one.